Lots of games have scrolling backgrounds, where the image is moving behind the player as they travel through the layout. If the layout size is fixed, this is easy to do, since you just have to set the background to fill the width of the layout. However, some games, like Flappy Bird, have scrolling backgrounds that loop endlessly. Let's take a look at how to set up an infinitely scrolling background. Let's start a new project. I'll set the viewport size to 960 by 540. And click Create. Now, the viewport size is 960 by 540, but the layout size is twice as big, 1920 by 1080. I want the layout size to be the same size as the viewport, so copy the viewport size and paste it into the layout size. Next, we need to add the background to the layout. To do this, we're going to use a tiled background object. Double-click the layout and select Tiled Background under the General category. I'm going to name it BG and click Insert. Click anywhere to place it, and then select the background image that you want to use. Whichever image you choose, it needs to seamlessly tile when it's sitting next to itself. Check the link in the description if you want to use the same image that I'm using. We need to resize it so that it's the same size as the layout. So hit Alt-R or click the Resize button and set the width to 960 and the height to 540. Also, I'm going to put a red dot over the right edge of the image so we can see exactly where this is tiling. I'll put it right on the edge. Next, we need to set the position to the upper left corner, which is 0, 0. We want the background to fill the screen, so set the size to the layout size, 960 by 540. Duplicate the BG object by holding Ctrl and click and drag a copy out. Since we're scrolling to the left, we need the second BG object to be placed just to the right of the first BG object. Set its position to 960 and 0, which puts it right next to the other BG object. Next, we're going to implement the scrolling, and to do that, we're going to move both of them to the left every tick. Once the first BG completely leaves the screen, which will put it at an X position of negative 960, the other BG will have an X position of 0. We need to set the X position of the first BG object to be placed just after the second BG object. Switch over to the event sheet and add a global variable. I'll name it BG_speed and set its initial value to 250. This will control how fast the BG objects scroll. First, we need to scroll the objects to the left, which we're going to do on every tick. Add an event using the system object and choose every tick under the general category. Add an action using the BG object and choose set X under size and position. We need to take the current X position and subtract from it the BG speed, and we'll multiply that times delta time to normalize it. Enter BG.X to reference the current X position. And we're going to subtract BG_speed multiplied by DT. If I press F5 and preview the layout, each of the BG objects scrolls off the screen to the left. But as the second one starts to leave the screen, we can see the white background behind it. We need to reposition the first BG object so that it trails behind the second. Add an event using the BG object and select Compare X under Size and Position. The BG object has a width of 960, so once it's less than or equal to negative 960 pixels, it will be completely off the screen. Add an action using the BG object and choose Set X. At this point, a lot of people run into a problem because they set the X position directly to 960. Watch what happens if I do that. After the BG object is repositioned, it can sometimes have a small gap between it and the other BG object. It doesn't always happen, but it happens enough that it won't work for what we're trying to do. The problem is, sometimes the BG object will move more than one pixel in a tick, jumping past negative 960, which means the second BG object would have moved past an X position of 0, leaving a gap between the two. There's an easy way to fix this issue, though. All we need to do is add 1920 to the current X position of the background. Since its width is 960, adding 960 would put it directly on top of the other BG object. So if we double that and add 1920, that puts it right next to it. So just set X to BG.X plus 1920, or double the width of the layout. Now, when we preview the layout, the background scrolls seamlessly for as long as the layout is open. We could speed it up, let's say to 600, and it still scrolls seamlessly. That's all there is to setting up an infinitely scrolling background. You can make it scroll in different directions with the same concept. Just do the opposite to scroll to the right, and replace X with Y to scroll either up or down.